Hello everybody, welcome to an episode of How to DIYRC to the Eachine E58 upgrade and mod series. Today's episode we're going to upgrade the range of the drone itself. 160 meters is nice, but we would like to have a lot more. 500 meters, 1 kilometer, that would be a nice target. And the only way that we are going to get there is by upgrading the antenna to a dipole 2.4 GHz antenna, and therefore we also need an SMA connector with a pigtail that we have to modify and solder to the drone or to the transmitter or to both. But it is a heavy upgrade. This weighs already 30 grams and I got only 30 grams to spare that this drone can lift the E58. So before we're going to do this upgrade to the drone, I first only want to try this upgrade to the transmitter and see how much we have extended the range before we're also going to add it to the drone and then hopefully extend the range even more. Let's dig in. Disassemble the transmitter. We have disassembled the E58 transmitter. There's only 5 screws in the rear and then 2 screws here at the front to hold that circuit board in its place. You need to be a little bit careful because there are a few wires running to the battery connection. A lot more than usual, but I want to show you that we have the antenna coming in over here. It's going to be the positive wire, the inside wire of the cable. And then we have a ground, and this is where the outside wires are going to. And this should hopefully really improve the range. Let's get to it. I'm going to be putting the antenna on the top, that way we have more space. We can put it above the circuit board. Well, we can use a lot of extra length. You never know when you have to show it up. So let's cut the wire in half and open it up. And free up the inner and outer cables. You cut it in half, you remove the outside wire for about an inch. And then you peel back the outside wires. And then the positive wire is the one that's inside this little plastic. You just have to open it a little bit, just a tip. And it's darn difficult to see, but we have stripped up just the tip of the positive wire. Now we are going to bundle the negative wires together. After soldering this pigtail, where the wires from the positive are super weak, you don't want it to move around anymore. So we're first going to install it and drill the hole in the transmitter case. And I'm using a 5mm drill. So we drilled the hole at 5.5mm, and just a half mil too short for the screw thread. That makes it just sit really tight and don't move around. I like that. I really need to screw it in and make my own screw threads. That will make the antenna jet a lot more secure. We went ahead and we pre-tinted the wires. You can see we tinted the positive wires and the negative wires. And we did the same for our extra lead for the ground wire. And I kept the lead extra long so we can move around if we need to. Now we have to desolder the original antenna. And that was the antenna lead poking out. Not the most difficult soldering. Now we have to solder the positive lead to where the antenna used to be. That was a figgly job, but we managed to solder the positive to the antenna lead. Now we need to be very careful. Take the negative wire, that looks the ground wire, and solder that to the second. No, it doesn't really matter how. Now we need to be very careful. And now you see why we need to be careful, because the joint, solder joint is super weak. So we came up with a little idea to run a second wire from that antenna lead and run that to the positive wire and give that a little bit more flex, and then use some hot glue to glue it down in position so the solder joint will not break. That solder firmly. To prevent the wire from snagging on that solder joint, we are going to screw down the circuit board first. Now we can solder that extra wire to the positive and then hot glue it down to the circuit board and just keep it there for a couple of minutes. It will take for you just a second. And now that we have fixed that problem, there's only one thing to do, and that's rebuilding the transmitter. And with the transmitter completely assembled again, there's only one more thing that we have to do, and that's adding antenna. So we're gonna put that on before turning on the transmitter. Always put on an antenna, of course. And I'm really pretty interested in seeing how much more range that we have now and still keeping the quadcopter as light as possible. But that will be coming up in the next episode. So if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe and click that notification bell so you don't miss the new episode that's coming up. And if you have any questions, then of course leave them down below. And if you're interested in this dipole antenna and the upgrade that we made, you find the links from the products down below. And I want to thank you for watching this video all the way to the end. And I want to say goodbye. Until next time.